Yo, what's happening, Sleepwalkers crew? Well, had some technical difficulties. Buddy Cat was helping me out, figure it out, and I think we're good now. So, Better now. What up, Jenny D? Say hi.
Hi.
Alright, anyways, I'm gonna get on the PTR. And we'll get this dialed in. My wife and I just moved, so in new house and getting everything set up. But I'm gonna jump into the PTR tonight and just kind of play around with some of the talents, see some of the changes, and then probably do some videos as well. Upload them to YouTube on just the talent changes and whatnot. So hang out tonight with me, and we'll jump into it. All right, so first one I think I'm going to jump into is actually my Death Knight. I heard Run Holy was really cool, got a chance to play around on it a little bit, but just want to kind of deep dive into it a little bit more and check it out. If you guys have any questions, I do have my other monitor going, so feel free to ask questions or whatever's going on. All right, so first things first, we're going to go to Stormwind. So here we go. And I've already kind of set up my Unholy DK. Can't use, obviously, ads and whatnot, add-ons and whatnot in the PTR like you can in live. So I'm limited to, just a standard UI. I'm trying to adjust the camera here. There you go. Limited to the standard UI, but have a lot of the keybinds that I'm going to be using. At least a little bit where they're at. I didn't make any macros or anything, but should be suffice. So basically, PTR. Biggest things that are incoming are the talent changes. That's huge. They've pruned a lot of them, but in my opinion, I think it flows like a lot better. The other huge thing, obviously, is going to be the appearance. And since we're talking about it, we're just going to jump into it. So where your collections is at, you're just going to go there, and then they have this tab right here. Called appearances, and so that's the new transmog. Of course, you have to still go to the nether. What are they called? The nether, whatever transmog guy. You still have to go to him, but these are going to be all your appearances that you have locked, unlocked. See, it says. Visit a transmogrifier to apply this appearance to your outfit. But I mean, really cool still. Like, it's all right here, and you can play around with it. Save things, shoulders, chest, tabards. Pretty neat, as far as I'm concerned. Saves you some gold, saves you bank space. It's flipping awesome. Different swords that you've unlocked, shield. So then you can obviously come in here and save it. Save different appearances so that you don't have to just kind of filter through and scroll through. So that's the other big thing coming in the pre-patch. My guess, pre-patch is going to hit the 19th, next Tuesday, guys. That's a guess, just from reading online and going through it. So if you haven't already, of course, the moose. I heard the moose is going to be a rare drop from Heroic Archimonde, but I've also heard that it's not going to be there whatsoever. The one thing that I'm certain of is that it's not a guaranteed drop for the quest, if it's going to be there. So with that said, I would highly suggest getting on it and making sure that you have that before that's taken out. Anyways, guys, let me get some sound going on here with the game so that there we go. Adjust levels a little bit. There we go. All right. Here we go. So, this is what the invasion is going to look like. There's going to be circles over here. Basically, these indicate that that's where an invasion is happening. You go to those and there's basically stages. You'll fight through stages with everybody else in the world. And then drops gear and nether shards in boxes. So really kind of cool. Is it going to keep us busy for over a month until Legion? I doubt it. But at least it's something to do. You can catch up all your alts on gear and just do it to it. So that's what it is, folks. I mean, I wish I could say that there was more to it, right? Maybe there is and I'm missing it, but this is what I've seen in the PTR so far. So, but let's fly over to one of these invasions and check it out. Check out how the Unholy Death Knight kind of playstyle is now, too. I feel like it's really cool. I'm having a hard time deciding on whether I'm going to keep maining a DK this expansion or switch to a Fury Warrior, because Fury is really fun too. Probably the next thing we'll play. So today was really eventful for me. Kind of stoked on learning how to use some video editing software and creating some stuff like that so that I can get better at some streaming stuff. Of course, there's just stuff I want to tweak. There's just things that I would like to do to make it more professional, to make it to where I don't have these hangups and just get good at it. You know, it takes time, and so I appreciate the views, whether you're viewing this live now or later on. So I highly appreciate it. All right, so this is an invasion, guys. Let's get to it. Let's battle some demons. So, main thing about a Death Knight, an unholy Death Knight, that is, one of the main things to keep in mind, that I don't even have my pet up, what a noob, anyways, is that you're using now these pestilential glands, or these, what do they call them, festering wounds. There we go, these festering wounds, and these festering wounds stack up to 8 times from your festering strike. Okay, and once you've stacked them, you can start destroying them. Okay, that's what I've done my research online and kind of played around with. Now here's the other cool thing. So get some festering glands going on. Pop that, pop that, pop that. Now, throw down D&D and pop them. And that'll hit everything that's in D&D. It's a freaking retarded AoE. Evidently, I have the Valkyr chosen as one of my talents. I'm out of range. So this isn't going to be like an in-depth kind of stream or guide in any way. It's flying by the seat of my pants kind of thing. I have spent some time playing the Death Knight, but I will record a video and upload it to YouTube so that you guys get more of a breakdown and can edit it, and it'll be a little bit more professional on what I'm saying, what I'm doing. That way you guys can follow along a little bit better on the rotation, on how to play it. But I figured while I'm doing it, I might as well explain to the best of my ability. So there's a boss. We're still on stage one. Once it gets to stage two, we'll have some other bosses and things to do here. Wow. TKs are just so strong. I'm so torn between playing this and a Warrior this X pack. I don't know. So torn. Warrior's fun. Haven't done a whole lot of practicing rotation stuff and play style, but as you probably tell, but it is what it is, guys. I'm just so glad that Unholy is looking so much more viable. So much more viable. Dang, look at all these people. I think I love this part of every expansion. It reminds me a lot of like when Burning Crusade was released, and that X-Pack, just in the invasion style and whatnot. But I just love being able to like nuke stuff with other players. And yeah, I think it's gonna be really cool, and just look forward to it, guys. I'm a little bored with Legion, or I mean with Warlords.
I need a target.
And the PTR is just added to the PTR. Oh, we have aggro. We're gonna die. Bosses hit hard. And that's one thing I've heard a lot in some of the VODs I've watched, some of the people I've followed, is that bosses hit harder. The mobs hit hard. I think they hit a little bit harder than previous leveling and like previous expansions. My opinion, it was fun, don't get me wrong, but Pandaria, I leveled my DK, almost hit realm first, and they had that. I was disappointed I didn't. Should have. But, basically, took a wrong turn in my leveling, and the dude that right behind me got ahead of me, and I lost it. Blew it right at the end. But it's all good. Things happen. This is it, boys. So fun. I think it, I don't think it's going to last us into Legion. I really don't. I think that it's gonna be better than what we got now, but it's still not a whole lot, in my opinion. I am still excited. I love Warcraft. I think Blizzard's a great company. They do it better than anybody else out there. But do I think this is gonna keep us busy for a month while we chomp at the bit for Legion? No, I don't. But it is what it is, guys. Better than any other game out there, I believe. Oh, wonderful. We have aggro. Take aggro! We're gonna die! Wow. Really cool if tank came in and took that from me. Another thing, Death and Decay, I didn't really touch base on it, right? Death and Decay now, when you throw it down, it basically mimics your attacks on other mobs, from what I understand. So, while you remain within the area, your Scourge Strike will hit all the enemies. So, it's only Scourge Strike. I thought it was all of them. But still, that's awesome because then you can apply, you basically go through, apply Festering Strike to get the Festering Wounds up on, and you tap target, right? Like, tap through, hit all the targets, if you're doing AoE, right? Hit all the targets, create all those Festering Wounds, and then just pop all those Festering Wounds with Scourge Strike. So Festering Wound everything up and just let them have it. Whoops. So, I don't know, I'm excited. The AoE is insane, I feel. Feels insane. So, going over here and wreck some shiz. I wish that. Now, there's different, like, encounters, right? Like, you saw when I brought up the map earlier that there's different areas, right? And each of those areas, they feel a little bit more unique than. They feel unique. You know, I wouldn't say, like, they're amazingly different. But they're different enough to give it a different feel, so don't think that it's just gonna be it's similar, right? But they have a different feel, like different mobs and stuff. So, like, I feel like up towards what is it? Yeah, Dunmoreau. Up in that area. I feel like there's a lot, like you can do a lot more AoE, like mobs, there's more of them and that sort of thing. So, oh, by the way, got my Grove Warden today. I'm really stoked. How I missed it, I don't know, but my guild moved on from. Moved on from heroic content, and so all we were doing is mythic progression, and we weren't doing any kind of heroic. So I somehow missed out on it with my guild. Finally got it today. By the way, if you haven't got your Grove Warden mount, I highly suggest getting into heroic Archmon because with the pre-patch, not even with Legion, with the pre-patch, they are removing it. From what I read, they're removing it completely. I have heard that it's now going to become a rare drop, but from what I read on Blizzard's notes, the rare drop is going to be the Felsteel Annihilator, one that drops off Mythic Archie, not Heroic. So I would highly suggest that, especially if you're a mount collector. Say hi to Jenny D. What up, Jen? My lovely wife puts up with my gaming. She went and watched the movie with me, the Warcraft movie. Loved it.
I need to target something first.
And she's not a gamer, so
I'm out of range.
highly suggest anybody go watch that. It's flipping awesome. You don't have to know the Warcraft lore to enjoy it. Welcome. Looks like we have another visitor. For some reason my viewers list isn't updating, but I see you. Feel free to ask anything. We're just playing some pre-TR right now. Going through it.
I don't have a target.
Fairly new to the streaming thing. But I do have a lot of friends that do it successfully, or a few friends, I should say, not a lot. and have a great vision for it. There's just there's some things I feel like could be done and would be fun to do. I feel like I'm gonna get into vlogging some things too, and I'm just uploading different things that I have knowledge about. Maybe some fight game stuff.
I need to target something first.
I'm here in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and trained underneath Greg Jackson for the number of years and know a lot of those fighters. Probably will at some point when I get my butt back in shape go take some privates, and if some of the fighters who I would choose to do that with me would allow me to record it, do that, and kind of just do some neat stuff like that. When I get tattooed, obviously I'm heavily tattooed, vlog some of that stuff. As you can see at the top of your screen, there's some other things I want to do as well. I should have been spreading that. Too many of them. Heal. Wrecked. We need a tank. Where's our tank? And or a healer, that'd be nice. Anyways, I have been in contact with some of the friends I have that do DJing. My wife and I went through a move. We moved out of the city into a small town on the other side of the mountains from Albuquerque. So just a good like family thing. It's so relaxing out here, and good family move for us. So that kind of is the reason I haven't streamed a whole lot, haven't had some of the things come to pass, like some live graffiti, live DJing, and that sort of thing. And probably will vlog them. May do them in conjunction with my stream as well. I don't know. We'll just have to see. Just depends on who it is and what they feel like doing. Which DJ and whoever wants to do the graph stuff.
I need to target something first.
So this is it. And it doesn't look like there's a whole lot of people doing it but us. So it's going up really slow. Huh. I think one of the coolest things about this is that it will be dropping 700 gear. So if you're thinking about maining maybe a character that's been your alt for Warlords, or maybe one you're thinking about maining something, you know, you didn't play a whole lot, all you have to do is get it to 100 and you have some makeup gear. I played the Outlaw Rogue too, just a little bit, and man, that's fun. There's a lot of RNG involved, a lot of RNG with Roll the Bones and whatnot, but it's just fun, you know. I don't know if it's gonna be, and probably won't be, the main rating spec, but definitely is good PvP, I'd say.
I need to get closer.
Good night, honey. Everybody say good night to Jenny D. Jenny D. He's probably the biggest gangster you'll ever meet, and have to be careful. She is Hispanic, she'll shank you in your sleep. Could happen.
It's too far away.
These things are brutal, dude. Like more for like ranged.
I'm out of range.
Basically soak those AoE poops.
I need a target. I need to go. I'm out of range. I need to target something first. It's too far away.
This is it, guys. It's gonna be more fun, I believe. I'm gonna die again. It's gonna be more fun when everybody's like around, you know, like when the whole realm is doing it, because right now evidently it's so late that it's like me and a few other toons roaming around, and it's just going slow.
I'm out of
still
range.
DK is fun. I'd also like how Outbreak applies. It's almost, it reminds me of Shadow Ward Pain. Disc spell, priest spell. So you can apply the crap out of it over and over. Now you don't need to. It evidently right now, the way it works is it applies necrotic plague and spreads. So you have that AoE happening, right? You can then apply your Festering Strike to apply Festering Runes to whatever mobs are around. You can then lay down Death and Decay, which not only will damage, but also causes your Scourge Strike to hit all of the targets within Death and Decay, as well as pop their Festering Wounds that are applied with Festering Strike. It's pretty freaking cool, guys. AoE, I think, is gonna be insane with Unholy. Good grief, dude. Can we have a tank somewhere? Just keep dying, and this looks like death. Yes, and it is wrecked again. Mwah, mwah, mwah. This is, PTR, I'm finding tonight is better played during the day when there's more people on, because these are just pretty crappy to do just a few people. And a lot of people, most people aren't, I've found, aren't trying out tanks and healers. They're more trying out DPS and checking out DPS changes. Yes. Tomoruku splat went up in the air and got wrecked. I feel like I should just go kill little mobs around the big guy, because this is AIDS. It looks like we got a tank over there, or something. Maybe not, they just got... I just saw him fly off the screen. Yeah, I know what that feels like. Feels really bad. Feels really bad. Let's get up our goal. Ha! Is that my buddy cat? No, I have a glider, I just
I
don't
need
have
to
it on my
focus.
toolbar. But yeah, I have gliders. In fact, I've been,
It's too
from what I've
fast.
watched, man,
I'm out of range.
They're gonna come in really handy leveling, because there's a lot of areas, like, that have cliffs and whatnot, so. Yeah. I've been stocking up on them. I think they're on, a lot of them are on my Fury Warrior, too. That and what was the other thing? Oh, there's a lot of water. So like one thing I wanted to get done was the Water Strider. And I started in on it, but then I read that they're taking it out. So who cares? Like, I don't know. It's not priority anymore. Basically, the Water Striders, like, you'll be able to use the one from Nat Pagel and Warlords from the Achieve, or from buying it from Nat Pagel, I should say, and all the Warlords Achieves you have to get for fishing Shack level 3. You'll be able to use that in Warlords, but you won't be able to use that in Legion. And same goes with the Pandaria one, which I think is kind of lame, but they're trying to gate. I feel like they're trying to gate leveling in some ways, so that it lasts longer for those that complain about no content. Possibly. Except unsub. Unsub what, dude? Tomaruku, that's gotta be flippin'. Is that cat? Gotta be cat. Why would I unsub, bro? Why would I unsub?
I don't have a target.
And down goes the little mouse. Oh, ha! Yeah, I think it's kind of lame. I've never bothered the getting the Striders, but yeah, I think it's kind of lame. They're not going to be in. Finally, the final stage of the Sentinel Hill invasion.
It's too far away.
I feel like this even isn't even the Demon Lord though. Kite, 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 we're gonna die. Be really cool if we had some healers, huh? And I didn't have aggro. Gosh, damn. So, yeah. Want to buy tank? Anybody want to get on and tank for me? Huh? Catrick. I know that's you, Tomaruku. It's gotta be. Get on tank for me, bro. Lame. Did you see how my laugh out loud matched my LOL? Dual box it? What do you mean dual box it, bud? I don't know what dual boxing is, dude. Oh, you mean like play a tank and a DPS or whatever. Yeah. I've had enough problems tonight managing my two monitors and getting OBS to cooperate with both of them. Dual boxing is out of the question. This is pretty much horrible. I think we have some food. Let me eat some food, maybe. That's PTR, so we'll blow some runes too. Okay, honey. Again. That looks bad.
I need to get closer.
Like it's gonna hurt her little scream crap. That looks bad too. Purple. Probably not good.
I'm out of range.
Damn, Daniel. Probably the only effing DPS with mythic gear, so I keep getting all the damn aggro. We'll get this done and out of the way, and then we'll move on to another tune. I'll probably, just for the sake of uploading this to YouTube, stop the stream and then restart, and that way it's split into a couple videos, and I can upload it directly from Twitch to YouTube. But I'm not going anywhere. Kids are in bed, wife's in bed, and I'm up. In fact, I got some coffee. Seconds. Put me back in, coach. Put me back in. I'm not sure you can edit, dude, like, well, so, I'm not sure how you would do that necessarily, like, because I'm not recording my stream, does that make sense? I'm not, like, recording my stream to my hard drive, like, it's just recording on Twitch, so the only, gosh damn it. Whatever that is sucks. You have to kite it evidently away from the group. It leaves like a little snail trail. A little snail trail of green AIDS, and I'm fucking dead again. Not sure if you can download it, man. Like, I know you can upload, like, I know you can upload it to YouTube and, like, YouTube, or yeah, YouTube and whatnot, but I don't know if you could download the vid from Twitch, if that's what you mean. So this is pretty much dumb. I have to wait. Stupid. Oh well, you know what we're gonna do? Switch characters. Yeah, right? Six. Shut up, cat. Catricia. We're gonna log out. That's what we're gonna do, and switch characters. You can laugh all you want to, Catricia, but here's the real deal. I was taking the aggro because I had the best gear in the party, and not a tank. That's what was happening. No tank to hold it for me. Okay? It's never happened in raid, ever. Only when you're tanking. Hey, Katrick, what do you want to see, dude? Seems to be pretty much me and you hanging out, bro. So if anything you want to see played or just holler at your boy, dude. Oh, shut up, dude. What, like, am I gonna like spam Death Strike, Death Strike, Death Strike? No. Can't even do that. This you have to generate, so it takes runic power in Legion now. No, I haven't created a pally, dude. If you want me to, I'll create one, dude, here. Let's do a pally, bro. You want a pally? I'm gonna do a pally for you, cat. Oh, now outlaw? Okay, outlaw. We'll do outlaw. All right. Like I said, stop the stream. And I'm gonna restart it. I'll be right back. All right. And I'll start the outlaw.